Hello student, let us start today exercise 4.6. Your first question is, question number 1, examine the consistency of the system of equations. Your equations are x plus 2y equal to 2 and 2x plus 3y equal to 3. So you see, system of equation means, you know that what does it mean? Means more than one equation is given. Okay, here we have two equations is given. Now you have to see, you have to check the consistency. Consistent, when we call a system of equation is consistent. Hope you remember, if a system of equation has solution, it may be one or many, the system is said to be consistent. And you see, we can check whether the system is consistent or not by finding out the value of the determinant of the coefficient matrix. So if the value of the determinant of coefficient matrix is not equal to 0, then the system is consistent and it has unique solution. Or if sometime what happened, the value of determinant of the coefficient matrix is equal to 0, in that case the system may be consistent or may not be consistent. If it is not consistent, it is said to be inconsistent. And if suppose determinant of A is equal to 0, in that case what you have to do, you have to find out the adjoint of the matrix and multiply them with the constant matrix, constant column matrix, and then if it is not equal to 0, the system is inconsistent, and if it is equal to 0, it is consistent but has many solution. So let us proceed to this question. First, let us write down the system of equation. So your given system of equation is x plus 2y equal to 2 and 2x plus 3y equal to 3. Now from here you can write down its matrix form. So what is the matrix form? The system of equation can be written in the form Ax equal to B, where A represents, what is A? A is the matrix formed by the coefficient of x and y. You see, here we have two variables, so we'll get a matrix of order 2 by 2. So here this is your A. What is A? You see, you have to write down the first, the coefficient of x is 1, here y coefficient is 2. So the first row will be 1, 2. In this equation, the coefficient of x is 2 and the coefficient of y is 3. So the second row will be 2, 3. And x, what is x? X is the column matrix of the variable. And that is what capital X is, column matrix XY, because you have these two variables. And B is the constant matrix of column matrix. So here you have the right side is twice 2 and 3. So this is 2 and 3. And you remember always that always you have to put the equation in this form. That is, you put the variables in one side and the constant on the other side. Always, this is necessary. After this, you have to find out the determinant value of this matrix. So put this matrix in the determinant form, that is determinant of first row 1, 2, second row 2, 3. And if you expand the determinant, what is the value we'll get? 1 into 3 minus 2 into 2. Okay, this will obtain. 1 into 3 value is 3, 2 into 2 is 4. So calculated value is minus 1. So that means it is not equal to 0. Since it is not equal to 0, that is, it is said to be non-singular. So therefore, A inverse exists. So since A is not equal to 0 and A inverse exists, then we can say that the system is consistent. And you see, you have only one solution, unique solution for the system of equation. But here it is not asked to find out the solution. Simply it is asked whether it is consistent or not, that you have to check. So we have checked it, that since determinant of A is not equal to 0, the given system is consistent. Hope you understand the method. Next, let us proceed to the question number 2. So your question number 2 is similar type of question. Examine the consistency of the following of the system of equation. Your equation is 2x minus y equal to 5, x plus y equal to 4. So first write down your system of equation. So you have to write down like this same equation, put it in the matrix form. So what is the coefficient matrix we'll get? The first row is x coefficient is 2, y coefficient is minus 1. Because your form is ax plus by plus cz equal to d form. Okay, so a is 2 and b is minus 1. So the first row is 2 and minus 1. Second row is coefficient of x is 1 and y is also 1. So second row is equal to what? 1, 1. So this is your coefficient matrix A. Then you have two variables. So it's a 2 by 2 matrix we have got. And here the variables are x and y. And the constants are what? 5 and 4. Okay, so after this, let us find out what is the determinant value of this matrix. This is in this form Ax equal to B. Okay, let us find out now determinant of A value. What is the determinant of A value? 2 into 1 minus 1 into minus 1. So calculated value 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, not equal to 0. So since A is non-singular, that means not equal to 0, therefore A inverse exists and we can say the system of equation is consistent. Okay, similar type of question we have done too. Now let us proceed to the next question, number 3. Examine the consistency of the equation x plus 3y equal to 5, 2x plus 6y equal to 8. So first you write down your system of equation, then put it in the matrix form. So matrix form, what is the matrix form? Ax equal to b. The given system of equation can be written in the form Ax equal to b. Where what is A? A is the coefficient matrix 1, 3, first row, second row, 2, 6. Okay, x is xy and column matrix is 5, 6. Now let us get the value of the determinant of A value. Determinant of A value is equal to what? 1 into 6, that is 6, minus 3 to 0, 6, 6 minus 6 equal to 0. So A is singular. Then, as I told you earlier, that is if A is singular, then the system may be consistent, may not be consistent. It depends. After finding out the adjoint of A into B value, we can decide whether it is consistent or not. So let us proceed to adjoint of A. And adjoint, hope you remember what is adjoint. Adjoint is obtained by taking the transpose of the cofactor. So first find out the cofactor. Cofactor A11 is equal to what? Minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1. Delete the row and the column into the minor, and minor is 6. So calculated value is equal to 6. Then 1, 2. Minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2. This value we have to get. So it will be negative. First row, second column deleted, but 2 is left. So the value is minus 2. Then second row, first column, 2, 1. Minus 1 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 and 1 deleted. That is 3 is left. 2 minus 3 is the value. 2, 2. This second row, second column deleted, 1 is left. Minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 into 1. The calculated value is 1. Now let us write down the adjoint. Directly let me write down the adjoint by taking the transpose. Okay, so first row elements are 6 and minus 2. So that we, let us write down in the form of columns. 6 minus 2 is the first column. And minus 3, 1 is the second column. So we have got adjoint. After getting adjoint, you do the product of adjoint of A with B. Then here, first write down your adjoint of A and the matrix B. You have already matrix B is what? Column matrix 5, 8. So put it here. This one. Substitute, calculate, you have first row, first column, this is 5, says 30 plus minus 24. And second row, second column, that is what? Minus 10 plus 8. So calculate that value is 6 minus 2, not equal to 0 matrix. So as I told you earlier, that is if not equal to 0, the system is said to be inconsistent. Okay, the solution of the given system of equation does not exist, hence the system is inconsistent. If suppose after doing the product, you got a 0 matrix, then in that case, your conclusion will be the system is consistent and that will have infinitely many solutions. Okay, now let us go to a 3 by 3 matrix. So examine the consistency of the following system of equation x plus y plus z 1, 2x plus 2y plus 2z equal to 2, ax plus ay plus 2a is equal to 4. So you see, since we have 3 variables here, x, y, z are 3 variables. So coefficient matrix will be a matrix of order 3 by 3. So first let us write down the given system of equation and then put it in the matrix form. So what is your A? X equal to B form. This is the matrix form. A is equal to what? 1, 1, 1. First row, second row, 2, 3, 2. Third row, A, 2. So this is done. And this is X. X is the column matrix variable X, Y, Z. And constants are 2, 3, 4 and 2, 1, 2 and 4. This is done. After that, let us find out the value of the determinant of A. What is the determinant of A value? 1, delete that row and the column. 3, just a minute. Okay. Here 3 to 0 6a minus twice a. Okay. Then minus 1. This is minus 1. Delete first row, second column. 2 to 0 4a minus twice a. Then plus 1. Delete first row, third column. 2 1 0 2a minus 3a. Now doing the calculation, we'll get 4a. Here it is 2a into 1 is 2a minus a. So doing a is not equal to 0. That is, a is non-singular. Therefore, a inverse exists. Hence, the system of equation is consistent. Because remember, simple thing, if A is not equal to 0, then it is always consistent and it has only one solution. After that, next question, examine the consistency of the system of equation. Here you see 3x minus y minus 2z equal to 2, 2y minus z equal to minus 1, 3x minus 5y equal to 3. The given system of equation, first let us write down, then put it in the matrix form. You see, first you have 3 variables, x, y, z, so you will give it the matrix of order 3 by 3. And in the equation here, you see the x variable is not present. So you may think it like this, 0 into x plus 2y. Okay, that variable which is not present, you consider that the coefficient as 0, multiply that coefficient variable by 0, and you will get that required term. And after that, you write down always 3 by 3. You cannot write down other 3 by 3 or 2 by 2. That means always you have to write down a square matrix. You cannot write down rectangular matrix. Okay, so your first matrix AX equal to B form, what is A? 3 minus 1 minus 2 is the first row. Then 0, 2, minus 1 is the second row. Third row, x is present, 3, x coefficient. Y coefficient is minus 5. But z coefficient is not there, so plus 0 into z, you can think like that. So 0 will be that coefficient, x, y, z. And this is 2, minus 1, 3. Okay, let us get the value of determinant of A, 3. 3 into, delete this row and the column, 2 zeros are 0, minus, minus, plus minus is minus, minus 5. Then you have the next is what? Minus 1, in terms of, I have expanded it in terms of first column. So positive, this is 2, 1 position, so negative, minus 0. 0 into something will give you 0, so I just keep it like this. And the third is 3, delete first row, third column, what is left? 1, minus, minus, plus 4. And doing the calculation, minus 15 plus 15 equal to 0. So we can say that, this, since determinant of A is equal to 0, the A is singular, so you cannot give the conclusion from here. So you have to find out the adjoint of the given matrix. Let us find out the adjoint now. How to get the adjoint? You know, I have done here the adjoint directly. So let me tell you how to get the adjoint. Here you see, the first, when you want to obtain the adjoint of 3, delete this row and the column. The symbol will be positive. Positive, deleting this row and the column, what is left? 0, minus, minus, plus, 5, plus, minus, minus, minus 5. So the first element is minus 5. You see this one. Then let us go to the second element. Okay, so what is the second element? This one. Symbol will be negative. First minus sign, remember it. Minus sign, this is deleted. 0 minus minus plus 3. So plus 3 into minus 1, that is equal to minus 3. You have to write down in this position because I have done the adjoint of A directly. Or if you want, you can find out the cofactor first, write down adjoint of A, its transpose form. And lastly, you write down in this form. Then let us get it and put it in this form, 3, 1 position. 3, 1 position, 1, 3 position is positive. So deleting this row and the column, 0 minus 6, minus 6, this is the value. Then second row, first column, this is the deleted. So second row, first column, negative symbol, this into this 0, minus 5, minus 10, or again minus 0 is there, so plus 10 will be the value. Okay, then similar way, when you do the calculation, you will get this is the adjoint of the matrix. After getting the adjoint of the matrix, let us multiply it with the B. When you do that, your B is 2 minus 1, 6, so doing the product, first row, first column, that is first element, minus 10, minus 10, plus 15. So minus 20 plus 15 will be minus 5. The second row, first column, minus 6, minus 6, plus 9. Okay, third row, first column, third row, first column, that is minus 12, minus 12, and plus 18. So doing the calculation, we have got this value, which is not equal to 0. So the system is what? Inconsistent. Hope you understand the method of getting the, how to check the consistency and inconsistency of a system of equation. Okay, so today I stop here. Thank you.